Hello everyone, welcome to All About Solar, Sun the Soul of All Energy. Today we are again back with a new episode of PVC software training. So in this video, I am going to give you an idea about the latest feature with the PVC software, like how you can create a single line diagram or SLD from PVC software. So before wasting any time, let's jump into the video. So here you can see that it is basically a project where I have already created the project according to the site location, and it is a 50 kilowatt project. So the first thing is that you have to create the project, you have to create the Meteo file, then you have to go to the project settings and consider the parameter like the albedo and what are the temperature is there. These parameters you have to consider. Then you have to consider the orientation. What is your specific orientation, like what will be the optimum tilt angle? If you want to know these steps, how to consider these parameters and these steps, please follow our PVC training series. It's already there in my channel. You can find it out on my cart. Now here I am directly coming on this system tab, because from this system tab only you can create the SLD. Now here what happens under this system tab, let's say I want to create a 50 kilowatt solar plant and I want to generate the report for a 50 kilowatt solar power plant. Now on this enter plant power option, I am just putting up the value of 50 kilowatt, right? Now when I just give 50 kilowatt and I have to consider the solar panel and solar inverter. Let's say here I am considering a Vikram solar panel, any of the panel you can consider. Let's say I am considering a latest 540 watt peak panel, and I want to consider a delta inverter 50 kilowatt. So I have considered here delta energy. I need to use the 50 kilowatt inverter. So that's why I have considered a 50 kilowatt inverter here. Now inside this MPPT option, here most of the people get confused with this option, like what he should choose, MPPT or multi-MPPT feature. So in this case, I'm not going to use the MPPT option. I am going to use that I have a 50 kilowatt plant and I want to use a 50 kilowatt inverter. So that's why I have used this 50 kilowatt one inverter. Now I need to consider the string. I am considering a 19 module string, like 19 module in a single series string. Okay, 19 into 5. If I consider that, the maximum array capacity which is coming as 51.3 kilowatt peak. Let's see, is it possible to load this capacity? Because I want to exactly match with the 50 kilowatt. So here it is coming 40 something. Now let me consider it 17 into 6. So at STC it has become 55.1, which is higher. Now 16 into 6 is become 51.8. So I think in this case the number of strings are increasing. So still I want to choose this 19 into 5. This will be fine. In this case you can see that array STC is 51.3 kilowatt, which is okay. Now in this case you can find that one option is coming here, single line diagram after your system overview. So you can, when you just click on single line diagram, it will show you that how many strings you have and how the inverter will be connected. So this is basically the option. And here, if you want to show this strings separately, that also you can do. Just right click on it and click on ungroup. When you just do ungroup, you can see that string wise it will show. Okay. And you can go to this view option. When you go to this view option, it will show you like this. So this is basically your diagram. Okay. And here you can see that injection point, inverter capacity, how many strings are there. Every single detail is mentioned. And you can consider this thing as a block diagram type of thing. It's not in a detail, a single line diagram. So that's a different type of thing for a detailed single line diagram. And here a few other things you can consider, like inverter symbol. You can change the inverter symbol from this inverter symbol button. there are different kind of symbol is available. Let's say I am considering symbol one, and like inverter to the injection point, the cable distance, this thing also you can mention here. You can see that you can zoom it from here. You can center your drawing in the just center point. That also you can do. And also you can choose the like paper where you want to save it. That's the basic thing of the SLD. Now here the site name, the details, the date, every single detail will be come up. Now, when you have done with this system part, now came to the detail losses. So in detail losses, how to consider parameters, how to consider thermal loss, all other loss. I have already described one of my video. There are two sessions for the detail losses. You can check out in the card button. Now to mention the distance of the cable or the cable size, you need to came here the ohmic losses. Now here, I am going to mention this AC loss, like it is basically a 50 kilowatt solar plant. So I am considering here, let's say I have a distance from the inverter to the injection point. Let's say it's about 50 meter. So I have considered 50 meter. According to that, for a 50 square mm copper cable, it is the loss is coming around 1.79%, which is fine. I am just clicking on OK. Now, you can again go to the single line diagramming. Here also single line diagram option is available. So now you can just look at this. As we have considered 50 meter cable, so it's also showing here the 50 meter. You can go to the view option again, and here also you can look at this, that 50 meter is mentioned here. So now we can run the simulation as well. So if I run the simulation here, now if we check the report, if we go to this report option, now here you can see this, the every single detail is there here in this particular report. And also we have considered the shading here. That's why it's also giving the shading diagram. Now the main thing came here just at the last of your report. You can see this is the single line diagram PVC is also giving you. Simulation date you can get with the latest version, PV, capacity, string numbers will be mentioned, for which site you are doing it. Every single detail you will get from here. So this is the way to create the SLD. And also you can, let's say, if you want to export a specific report or go to the save document, from this you can save this report. And also if you want separately the SLD diagram, then what you can do, you can go to the detail losses tab, go to the ohmic loss. Now you can go to the single line diagram and you can just go to the view option, and from here you can save this thing. From this you can paste it as an image as well, or else if you want to take it a PDF, you can also do that. So here you can see that we can save it. Like I want to save this document, so I am just saving it here as a circuit diagram. So you can see this. This is one of our previous site. So according to that site, I have just created this model. So you can see this easily. I can create a simple block diagram kind of thing, so that we can get an idea that how many strings we have considered and what is the distance from inverter point to the injection point. So this is a simple block diagram, but it is very useful. If you want to just give an idea to any of the site person who just connect your solar panel with the inverter, they can easily understand that how many strings are there and how to connect it with the inverter, what is the distance from inverter to the injection point. So this is just a block diagram. So that's all for today's video. If you want to learn more about solar power plant design and the design calculations and the software which is related to the solar power plant, we from Haven Institute of Renewable Energy is going to launch a new advanced solar power plant design course, where you can get to know about the solar power plant A to J design process and all the solar related softwares like SketchUp, PVC, AutoCAD, Scaleon, Helioscope. Each and every software which is related to solar plant, we are going to cover each and everything in this advanced course design. So if you want to grow your career in solar energy field, please join this training program. It will help you to get a high paying job in solar industry. So that's all for today's video. We'll catch you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. If you think this video is helpful for you, please hit the subscribe button and follow us for more.